While the Roman Empire fell in the year 476, the remains of the buildings and infrastructure they constructed persist even today. Structures like the Pantheon, which has survived for almost 2,000 years, are testaments to the Romans' engineering capabilities. But how could an ancient civilization create unreinforced concrete structures that have proven more durable than some modern ones? To investigate this, I've invited Dr. Admir Masic, an associate professor in MIT's Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering, who has made the news recently for his discoveries about the mechanisms behind the self-healing capabilities of Roman concrete. My name is Andrew, and you're watching What's the Matter With?, a video series from the MIT Concrete Sustainability Hub. Tune in to each episode to learn about a key topic in our research and in the industry at large. Admir, could you introduce some of your recent discoveries about ancient Roman concrete that have made the news recently?
Yes, so a lot of news. So we published a paper about the ancient Roman concrete that we studied in this lab here, using scanning electron microscopy and Raman microscopy that is here behind me. And what we found out is that Romans might have been using hot mixing in their way of making concretes and mortars. Hot mixing means that instead of using slaked lime, so lime that comes from the kiln in form of calcium oxide and then slaked with water and then put in mortar, we push the hypothesis in this paper that they might be using partially or completely the calcium oxide directly from the kiln in the form of little granules in the concrete mix. And this comes with a series of consequences that might have helped the Romans to build, might be a challenge for us to translate into modern analogs, but the most importantly for Romans, hot mixing would allow them to probably have a concrete mix cure, set and cured earlier, faster, and that would allow them to build faster. And the hot mixing using quicklime also has as a consequence the formation of lime clasts, and that's what we demonstrated in this paper, that if you use quicklime even in a modern setting, there is a systematic inclusion of lime granules in the concrete mix. That is already an important aspect of these hot mixed concretes, because eventually lime clasts might be the missing link in our picture on how this material, ancient Roman concrete, eventually self-heals. Till this paper was published, we assumed that the Roman concrete, ancient Roman concrete, strengthened over time, acquired strength over time by reactivity of its volcanic components. Volcanic components, or maybe synthetic pozzolans or other pozzolanic materials, that basically undergo constant recrystallization, forming these crystalline or amorphous calcium aluminum silicate hydrates. So that's definitely something that we believe it happens, and we are sure it happens in, for example, an ancient Roman tomb of Cecilia Metella, where at the interface between volcanic aggregates and cementitious matrix, we find calcium aluminum silicate hydrate using Raman spectroscopy.
So, Admir, could you talk to me a little bit about current and previous misconceptions about what these lime granules are?
I mean, many people looked into them because they are ubiquitous and typical for ancient Roman concretes. And because of the heterogeneity of lime clasts, we came up with many hypotheses. We means a community. These are things that really I need to credit to a vast community of scientists and engineers that looked into ancient Roman concretes. And you know, it could be like a bad mixing of your original mix. Your original mix is basically lime, volcanic powder and aggregates, sand and water. And if you indeed use slaked lime and don't mix properly, you will end up with inclusions of, again, lime. Inclusions, lime class. And this is what we kind of challenge in this paper. We think that, yes, in some instances, that was the reason. But in others, perhaps, is because quick lime creates the microenvironment around the calcium oxide that prevents water to basically dissolve these granules. And they get incorporated into the structure and eventually stuck after concrete is set and cured.
So in your mind, what are some of the implications of your research for modern mixtures?
Yeah, so we need to immediately state that what Romans did and how Romans built is different from how we build in modern time. Therefore, not everything that we learn from Romans is useful in modern construction industry. What though we believe is interesting functionality that we should try to translate from Romans into modern equivalence is self-healing property. And that's, I think, you know, the challenge that we will be taking in a very near future to basically design modern analogs that fit with the standards of construction, but still have this self-healing capability. And self-healing concretes are definitely something that is, you know, available there on the market. Unfortunately, they are expensive based on the solutions that we have. And what we hope that Roman inspired solution will bring is the competitiveness in terms of price.
How does this research reflect the commitment of the hub and the commitment of your lab to resilience research?
We agree that, we all agree, at least in our CS hub and with our colleagues, that cement and concrete are remarkable materials. Concrete is durable, strong, ubiquitous, and we know how to use it and make it at the very low expenses anywhere in the world. So it's very democratic material. Multifunctional concrete for us means that we introduce into the current solutions functionalities that will systematically reduce carbon footprint associated with production. This includes our self-healing functionality that will extend lifespan of what we build and eventually require less maintenance, less energy, less CO2. Numbers that is difficult to estimate, but on the long run, definitely will have a significant impact on carbon emissions.
So there you have it. Admir, in addition to researchers across MIT and other institutions, have offered us a valuable look into the properties that made ancient Roman concrete so durable. This self-healing mechanism, if successfully employed in modern mixes, could offer a new avenue for making concrete more sustainable and resilient. As usual, we will end with an open-ended question. What other lessons can we, as academics and industry professionals, take from the past to make our buildings and infrastructure stand the test of time?